What's up, guys, and welcome to this Team Health Tuesday. Today, I'd like to talk about one of the commonest mistakes which I see people make in their attempts to get fit, you know, do exercise and that kind of thing. And this is working at less than optimal intensity. What do I mean by intensity? Intensity is the force that you exert during an exercise. For example, if it is a bicep curl, it could be the load, so the weight which you're actually lifting on that bicep curl. It could be five kilograms, 7 kilograms, whatever it is. If it's a push-up, it could be the degree of difficulty of the progression which you've chosen to perform that push-up, or even just simply the force which you're actually exerting as you're doing the push-up. You see, our bodies never really understand that we have been in the gym. What our bodies understand is how hard have we pushed ourselves. Of course, hard within limits. We need to push ourselves hard, but then again, not too hard that we're not able to recover before the next session. So what does it mean bringing the right intensity to the workout? Say for this workout, my goal is perform 20 repetitions of push-ups for say 3 to 4 sets. I need to make sure that during each set of the push-ups, I'm only leaving 1, 2, at most 3 repetitions of those push-ups in the tank. So this means that I need to perform a variation of the push-up, which makes sure that I begin fatiguing, say, by about 18, 19 repetitions, such that I'm forcing through those remaining repetitions. So in my case, if it's 20 push-ups, I'll be doing the normal push-ups, push-ups on all fours, and I'll make sure that I'm not going too fast, so that I'm not just going through the motions, but I'm controlling the negative of push-up, which is as I go down, and then pushing up with maximum force. I should begin fatiguing at about 19, 20 repetitions. If my goal for the workout was, say, 8 to 12 repetitions, I'll then have to make the push-up variation harder. For this one, I would definitely need somebody to put a weight on my back. It could be, say, a 10-kilogram plate or 15-kilogram plate. Or if you have a child at home, a baby, you could ask them to sit on your back as you perform those push-ups to make sure that you actually fatigue by about 8 repetitions, such that you're really forcing through those remaining repetitions. If my goal was, say, 6 to 8 repetitions, I'll then maybe need to do bipedal push-ups. So push-ups alternating one leg and one hand on the ground while the other hand and the other leg are off the ground, just to try and make it a little bit harder. Then, of course, if you're like my friend Kenneth, and you're going for 6 to 8 repetitions of push-ups, you can just fly. In summary, if you want to progress and make gains, you have to push yourself hard. Unfortunately, there is no other way. I know some people like saying, train smart, but actually, you know, training smart actually means training hard, pushing yourself to the limit. You know, just keep redefining those limits as you keep progressing, getting leaner, getting stronger, getting healthier. All right, I hope you found that informative. If you did, share it with a friend, leave a comment below. Let us know what you want the next video to be on. Dr. Andrew Tiket from Team Health. Till next time, take care and peace.